From the depths of Zone emerges Jinx, a maniac and impulsive criminal whose only desire is to create chaos, unconcerned by the destruction she leaves behind. Or is it really like that? From Arcane we learned that Jinx is nothing more than a child grown with a lot of trauma. But in League we met her grown up, now named Jinx. Armed with a deadly array of weapons, she revels in unleashing the loudest blasts and most dazzling explosions, sparking fear and confusion wherever she roams. Boredom is her enemy, and she combats it by spreading her unique brand of pandemonium with reckless joy. Welcome, lore lovers, to another deep dive with Landrag. Today, we unravel the chaotic brilliance of Jinx, from her origins in Zone to her rise as Piltover's most notorious menace. Get ready for an explosive journey through the lore of Arcane and League of Legends. Let's jump right into the mayhem. Let me start with her lore from Arcane, as it is also the chronological order, where Jinx is just a little girl called Prowder that lived peacefully with her sister Vi and their parents. But tragedy struck when their parents perished during a battle on the bridge between Piltover and Zone. Left as the only survivors of their family, Prowder and Vi were taken in by Vendor, who raised them alongside Milo and Clagor. Years later, Prowder, Vi, Clagor and Milo ventured into Piltover, following a tip from Echo about a wealthy citizen. Inside the apartment, they looted the place, and Prowder found a box filled with mysterious blue crystals. However, in a rushed escape, she accidentally dropped one, causing a devastating explosion that alerted the enforcers. The group fled through the streets of Piltover, narrowly escaping capture. Once back in Zone, they were ambushed by Deckard's gang. While Vi, Clagor and Milo fought, Prowder was chased to the docks by a gang member. She attempted to defend herself with her gadget, Mauser, but it malfunctioned. In desperation, she tossed the stolen goods into the sea and barely escaped. Later, Milo scolded her for ruining the heist, labeling her a jinx, but Vi silenced him. At the last drop, Vendor reprimanded them for stirring up trouble in Piltover, though Vi argued that they had no choice given their harsh circumstances. To avoid further trouble, the group hid in a run-down arcade, where Milo mocked Prowder for her failures. However, she proved him wrong by demonstrating her remarkable aim on a target range. Soon after, enforcers stormed the arcade, forcing them to flee once again with Echo's help. Later, at the last drop, tensions rose as Zonites debated retaliation against Piltover, but Vendor insisted that peace was the only way forward. Prowder, still eager to help, crafted new bombs and showed them to Vi, who encouraged her. When Vendor was captured, Vi and the group devised a rescue plan. Prowder, wanting to help, was told to stay behind. Disrobed, she realized the crystals she had taken were responsible for the explosion. Determined to prove herself, she built a bomb and used it during the rescue mission. The explosion killed Milo, Clagor and several of Silco's men, leaving Vi and Vendor gravely injured. Heartbroken by the devastation, Vi called Prowder a jinx and abandoned her, leaving her devastated. Silco found her soon after and took her in. During Piltover's Progress Day, a group of Firelights ambushed a Shimmer shipment, and Prowder, now known as Jinx, responded with deadly force. She slaughtered the rebels with ease but was momentarily shaken when she mistook one for her sister Vi. Regaining her composure, she mercilessly shot the rebel. Jinx's relationship with Silco had grown into a twisted father-daughter bond, and though he showed care for her, she remained haunted by her past, keeping mementos of her lost loved ones in her hideout. After a destructive incident, Silco urged her to rest, but Jinx, desperate to prove herself, staged an attack on the Piltover Council building, stealing a Hextech crystal and killing several enforcers. Jinx later learned from Sevika that Vi was alive and searching for her. Using the flare Vi had once given her, she called for her sister. When Vi appeared, the two briefly reunited, but Jinx's trust was shaken when Caitlyn showed up. The trio was soon ambushed by the Firelights, leading to Vi and Caitlyn's capture and leaving Jinx once again alone. Jinx, now searching for both Vi and the Hextech gemstone, unleashed a swarm of mechanical butterflies that killed a group of enforcers on a barricaded bridge. She confronted Vi and Caitlyn but was interrupted by Echo, who engaged her in battle. Although evenly matched, Echo managed to pin her down before Jinx detonated a grenade, severely injuring them both. Silco found Jinx and took her to Singed, who saved her life by injecting her with Shimmer, though the process was excruciating. Jinx later captured Vi and brought her to a Twisted Tea party, where she had also tied up Silco and Caitlyn. Torn between her loyalties, she begged Vi to kill Caitlyn, but when Vi refused, Jinx turned her fury on Caitlyn herself. A scuffle ensued, ending with Jinx shooting and accidentally killing Silco. Distraught, Jinx took the Hextech-powered fishbones and fired a missile at the Piltover Council building, leaving the aftermath unknown. League's lore shows us only a grown-up Jinx, a maniac and impulsive criminal from Zone, lives for chaos, leaving a trail of destruction wherever she goes. Armed with an array of deadly weapons, she unleashes explosive havoc, driven by a deep hatred of boredom and a love for pandemonium. This side of the story highlights how people are viewing Jinx, as only a few know who she really is and her connections with Vi. No one knows exactly where Jinx came from, but countless urban legends surround her. Some say she was once a young girl who suffered tragedy or was driven mad by Zone's fumes. Others claim she isn't even human, but an avenging spirit seeking retribution for Zone's fall. Old-timers speak of a sweet, innocent tinkerer, but the Jinx they describe is far from the terror that now haunts Piltover. If you're enjoying this breakdown of Jinx Wild Story, don't forget to hit that like button and subscribe. Your support helps my channel grow, and together we can keep exploring fascinating worlds. Her crime spree grew more elaborate, culminating in a series of explosions that destroyed Piltover's prized art structures. Though no one was hurt, the city's leaders were furious at the destruction. Jinx continued her spree, mocking the wardens and leaving graffiti that taunted Enforcer Vi, Piltover's new ally in the fight against crime. These pink tags finally revealed her name, Jinx. Some in Zone saw her as a hero for defying the wealthy elites of Piltover, while others viewed her as a dangerous threat who would bring even more trouble to the Undercity. The tension escalated when Jinx sabotaged the Sun Gate, halting the flow of ships and costing Piltover's clans vast sums of money. She knew exactly which nerves to hit. Daringly, she announced her next target, the Ecliptic Vaults, one of Piltover's most secure treasuries, and even included a caricature of Vi on the walls. The city braced for the heist, with Vi, Caitlyn, and the wardens preparing a trap. When the bells tolled and nothing happened, it seemed Jinx had backed down, but she was already inside. Hidden in a coin crate, she had infiltrated the vault days earlier. As chaos erupted from within, Vi realized what was happening and stormed into the vaults, ignoring Caitlyn's orders. What followed was a battle of explosions and destruction as Jinx and Vi clashed, tearing the vaults apart. In the deepest chamber, they faced each other alone. Jinx fired rockets into the ceiling, collapsing the structure. Vi survived by hiding in the same lockbox Jinx had used to enter. But when she emerged, Jinx had vanished. The vault was destroyed, but no money had been taken. Only a final taunt from Jinx, daring Vi to catch her. To this day, Jinx remains a menace to Piltover, inspiring Kempunk copycats and becoming the subject of plays and rumors throughout the city. Her ultimate goal and her obsession with Vi remains a mystery, but her audacity and chaotic crimes only continue to grow. As I've said, Jinx is only known by few people, and besides her chaotic life and apparent criminal desires, she is but a broken child only seeking attention from the person she loves or once loved the most, Vi. As a relentless enforcer, Vi is determined to bring Jinx to justice no matter the cost. Their rivalry is deeply personal, with Jinx even taunting Vi by painting a crude image of her on the walls of the Ecliptic Vaults, one of Piltover's most secure locations. But no one can imagine what's inside Vi's heart, her only sister. Maybe even now she's still Powder to her. After each encounter, Vi is getting more heartbroken, seeing Powder being enveloped by Jinx. Echo, reflecting on their past, once admitted he had a crush on Jinx when they were younger. However, Jinx seems to show no recognition of their history, her memories clouded by the chaotic path she's taken. As the sharp-eyed sheriff of Piltover, Caitlyn is focused on capturing Jinx for the destruction she's caused. Like Vi, Caitlyn is relentless in her pursuit of the elusive criminal. During one of her wild adventures in Zone, Jinx encountered Ziggs, seeing through his Yordle disguise and mistaking him for a figment of her imagination, perhaps a manifestation of her conscience. Their shared love for explosions quickly bonded them, and Jinx persuaded Ziggs to join her in Zone after a night of reckless fun. Thanks for joining me on this explosive journey, lore lovers. If you enjoyed the video, be sure to like, share and subscribe. And if you are passionate about lore like I am, join our Discord to help build a community of fellow lore lovers. Until next time, stay curious and keep exploring.